I've always dreamed of going there one day. I'm Nairi Fuata, and this is my story. I was born in England in 1967, to a Dutch mother and an exotic father. My sisters and I had been to Holland many times, but Dad's origin was always a bit of a mystery, since he was from the other side of the world. We moved to Aotearoa in the early 70s. From the age of 8, I grew up in Whakatane on the east coast. And with my brown skin and curly hair, I always felt like a Māori. Only, I wasn't. In the late 80s, Auckland became my home, where I enjoyed some success in the music industry. These days, I work behind the scenes in film and television, and I'm mum to 8-year-old Ruby. I try and take her back to Whakatane as often as I can. My dad is Spasio Fuata, or Fu as everyone calls him, is in and out of hospital because of diabetes. Dad left the islands in the 50s to study to be a Catholic priest in Otago. He didn't quite make it to his final vows, but decided instead he wanted to be a teacher. So he was sent to London, and it's in London that he met my mum, Marion.
My wife was a member of the Hawaiian Club in Amsterdam, and when she came to London, she was looking for people of island origin. And somebody suggested, oh, I know this fella at the St. Mary's College. He would be just a man to meet you. So I was introduced to the Marion, and then she had a friend, you know. And then after a while, it was a matter of choosing which one to choose for a wife.
Oh, I thought he was so neat, man. And these lovely eyes, these mischievous eyes. And I wrote to my mum in Holland, I met this boyfriend I had, and the sunshine was coming out of his eyes.
When people say, where are you from? I said, I'm from Rotuma. And they said, where the hell is that? So, being in New Zealand for a few years, I said, oh, I'm from New Zealand. And people said, oh, he's a Māori, you see.
Dad never corrected anyone because he'd given up explaining where Rotuma was. Mum believed he was Māori. It wasn't till after we were born that Dad finally confessed.
Well, he said he was from New Zealand. I didn't know much about islanders at all. So in the beginning, he pretended to be a Māori from New Zealand.
Rotuma is a Polynesian outlier north of Suva and is governed by Fiji. About 2,000 people live there. Dad didn't want to bring us up in England and wanted to be closer to his Pacific homeland.
I always thought of returning to New Zealand. So when they were born, we gave them Māori names.
Soon after returning to Auckland, Mum called me to say that Dad had fallen seriously ill and had been moved to intensive care. My older sister Tiara, her daughter Caroline, Ruby and I have rushed back to Whakatane to see Dad. One of Dad's lifelong wishes is to take us to his homeland, Rotuma. But with his deteriorating health, it doesn't look like he'll make the long journey, and time is running out.
I think it's just time that I have to go, and I want to take Ruby, and I'd rather have this conversation about a trip to Rotuma with him while he's still around.
We've got lots to organise for the long trip ahead, so it's back to Auckland to get packing.
So this is now our medical kit.
We've never been to Rotuma before and have no idea what to expect, so we're packing everything except the kitchen sink.
It's fine. Bit of a crunch, but it's fine. It'll work.
I'm wondering if this city kid will be able to cope without her toys for a whole month. Getting to Rotuma isn't going to be easy. We have to fly to Fiji and then take a 36-hour boat trip to the island.
To access to a range of media for the duration of the flight, please follow the on-screen instructions.
Our ferry was supposed to depart from Lautoka, not far from Nandi. However, the boat is now leaving from Suva, so it's a rental car and a drive to the other side of the island.
Right, looks like we're on the road finally. Come on, Ruby. 3.5 hours to Suva now. It's going to be a long day. So we finally made it through.
After nearly half a day of driving through four seasons, we finally arrive in a very cosmopolitan Suva.
It's very busy. Sweet. Yeah. Just here, Bob.
Yeah. My cousin Fuata, Dad's namesake, has helped organise our trip and is waiting at our hotel to greet us.
Ruby, this is not what the islands are completely like. It's not going to be what it's going to be like on the boat or on Rotuma. But it's our last taste of a bit of comfort. Inco?
Only if we get KFC.
No KFC. We've been doing our final preparations for Rotuma. We've been getting water and mosquito nets and all the other stuff that we didn't bring from New Zealand.
Just purchased some travel sickness tablets for that long journey tomorrow. Essential.
I think it's going to be fairly basic on the boat, but I really don't know. We're just trying to get ready in every way possible so that if something sort of unexpected happens, we are prepared. Ruby doesn't know what's going to hit her. I don't think she quite expected what she's seen here in Suva. Shopping malls and cafes, KFC, you know, all the takeaways, places that you can get in New Zealand. And of course she's staying in quite a nice hotel. So tomorrow could be a bit of shock. So it may be the tantrums start from tomorrow, but fingers crossed she'll be able to cope.
They've told us it's too late to check in our bags, So Fuata's gone to try to get them onto one of the trucks going on the boat, while we try to get on as quickly as possible to get a good spot for the long journey ahead. Thankfully, Fuata's sister-in-law, Kijiana, has saved us a space next to her in the cabin area.
You're going to use this one and put your mattress over here.
Oh.
We're going to put our things there.
Okay, thank you.
Yes, I think I want to talk, thank goodness.
What up?
A bit fitter, because when you're lugging this much stuff.
Have you got a mattress? Do you have a mattress?
We've got some
sleeping bags.
Yeah, you weren't sleeping bags.
Oh, good.
So we're fine, she's going to pop it up.
The Westerland ferry was scheduled to leave Suva at 10 a.m. After 5 hours of sitting in the heat on the boat at Suva Wharf, we finally set sail for Rotuma. And if we thought getting on the boat was stressful, we're about to find out what this voyage is really like.
I bought my nose because it's more all over the toilet.
Oh, nice.
Somebody's breakfast, I think. It wasn't actually that long after we set off that that's been in there, so that's been sitting there for probably about 4 hours now. Because it won't drain.
Our first experiences on the boat aren't pretty, but this certainly is nothing short of spectacular. And in true Fijian tradition, there's only one way to salute the end of a day. With some world-famous Fijian cover.
Vinaka!
It takes never changes.
Back below deck, we join the queue of hungry passengers and choose the chicken and rice, because it's the only thing on the menu.
It's just as well, because all our food is downstairs. We'd have been starving by now.
After a long first day on the boat, it's time to turn out the lights and get some rest. Or at least, that's the plan.
We've just come up onto the top deck to get some fresh air. I'm not sure what time it is at the moment, but we managed to get a few hours sleep. It's quite incredible that we did, because between the snoring, the kids crying, and the party that's going on at the end of the boat, and the cockroaches and the heat, I don't know, we probably got about 3 hours sleep. When we got up to go to the toilet, I had three cockroaches stuck to my arm. So that's the boat experience.
Despite a mostly sleepless first night in the sweltering Pacific heat, the morning view was a beautiful yet daunting sight. The great Pacific Ocean, as far as the eye could see. Ruby's made some friends on the boat to keep her occupied, so I decide to talk to other Rotumans about why they're making the big journey home. For Fuata's stepson Lincoln, this will be his first time to Rotuma.
Rotuma's my homeland, and I haven't been there. I've been to Brisbane, I've been to Auckland, but I haven't been to Rotuma, so kind of off, so I have to go.
Kimberly Bennett is half Rotuman and half American. She was raised in Rotuma and now lives in Hawaii, where she's studying at university.
How important is it to you to keep making that trip back?
Really important, not only to see my family, but just to constantly experience my culture and hopefully one day pass that on, you know, to my kids.
Sunday evening and it's actually really lovely, very peaceful and calm and relaxing. I'm enjoying sitting at the front of the boat and
I just wish that I had a glass of wine in my hand as well. It would make it perfect. Well, we're closing the gap now. We should be hopefully on Rotuma this time tomorrow night. It's been a lot longer than I thought it was going to be. And today was especially bad down below because they turned off the air conditioning. They're trying to make the boat go faster. But it doesn't seem to be working. I'm trying not to get my expectations up about what I'm going to see. But I figure that it's taken so long to get there that there has to be some great reward at the end of it. And I'm sure that that's going to be really the island, yeah.
It's our third day on the Westerland Ferry, and we've barely slept a wink. We've been told that the wharf closes at 6 p.m, which means if we don't make it on time, we may have to spend another night on the boat. However, the seasickness tablets and Ruby's tolerance are wearing thin.
So do you think we'll get off at Wenawha tonight?
We should. According to Captain, he's trying his best to be there before 5.
Okay. That's not too bad. Do you know how many knots he's moving?
He was saying we were moving at 7.5 knots.
That's slower than a tugboat. What was originally supposed to be a 36-hour boat ride has now turned into 3 days and 2 nights. But all of a sudden, there it was.
There's Rotuma! 48 hours after we set off, we've finally seen the speck on the horizon. Let's hope we get off the boat tonight. Ruby, it's getting much bigger now, isn't it? It's a lot smaller than I thought it would be. But I'm still in a bit of disbelief. I can't quite believe that we're here. Because it's just taken so long. And it's in the middle of nowhere.
I wish Dad was here. I wanted him to take me home.
We finally landed on Rotuman soil. Yeah, really excited to see Alexio and to have a look around the island.
Thankfully, all of our luggage has made it here safely. Now we wait for my cousin, Alexio, Fuata's older brother. We've never met before, so this could be interesting. Amongst all the chaos, Kajiana spots Alexio's truck. Only moments after arriving at Alexio's house, we're greeted by a whare group. During the whare season in December and January, groups sing and dance outside houses. I guess it's sort of like a Rotuman version of caroling, only more interactive and a lot messier.
We've only just got here
Residents from the houses douse the whare group with perfume and talcum powder. I've heard different stories about the origin of this tradition. Some say it's a substitute for monetary gifts. Some say it's to keep away spirits. Whatever the reason, during whare, Rotumans of all ages are in party mode. But after a long journey on the boat, Ruby and I are keen to catch up on some real sleep on land. Tomorrow, we wake up in Rotuma.
Dad, it's Nairi. We're all safe and this place is cool. It's wet here at the moment.
Are you enjoying it?
Yep. It's beautiful, Dad. Just what you said it was. It's absolutely beautiful here.
Oh, I'm so glad for you.
Okay, bye-bye. Love you. Bye.
Bye-bye.